The Philippine Stock Exchange extends its losses on Friday. The main index shed nearly 0.5% to end the week at 65.30. Value turnover, meanwhile, returned to 4.5 billion pesos. To help us make sense of today's market movements, we're now joined by Christina Ulang. She's the head of research at First Metro Investment Corporation. Hi again, Christina. Good to have you on the program.
Hi again. Hi, good afternoon, Stanley. Thanks for having me.
Okay, now today was a bit depressing, confirming that the market is indeed trading in the 6,500 level, even touching 6,400 intraday. Now, what are the highlights of the day, Christina? What did you see as promising and disappointing at the same time?
I think there are a number of data that's going to come out next week. It's the inflation for the month of May. And then we have this decision by the U.S. federal authorities on the whether they're going to hike interest rates by 25 basis points, and then what will the BSP do in the light of that decision. So these are the factors that the markets are trying to price in now, and there is uncertainty with regard to all of this information that are yet to come out. But if you will notice, there's this strengthening of the US dollar, and that's really because of the rising U.S. interest rates, like the UST, U.S. 10-year U.S. Treasury now at 3.8%, coming from like 3.7%. And also credit spreads in the U.S. corporates are rising, and that's really because of the controversy, the impasse with regard to the U.S. debt ceiling. So all of these are playing into the local stocks, and then causing, of course, the U.S. dollar to be a bit on range-bound mode. Still, if you're going to see our local currency, it has gone up to like 56.10. When we began the day yesterday, it was like a 55.70. So we're seeing a dollar strength and weakness in the currency, and that's affecting actually the PSE performance.
Okay, and on that performance today, we look at the Actives Board. There was a Sana All moment there. Petron Corporation going against the grain, gaining more than 30%. In fact, intraday, stock price has been rising in recent days. What's going on with Petron, Christina?
I think they have a sort of fundraising, and that's going to really help them with regard to their corporate financing requirements, and then of course their rollout of ongoing expansion when it comes to the retail marketing. And I think it's very important that they're able to mobilize resources for future growth and of course refinancing requirements.
Okay, let's talk about the counters now. Biggest losing sectors today, services and financial services in particular, that's 1.25% down. What developments are affecting sentiments towards services?
Financial services, they've been on a good run, rally, like a BDO, Metrobank, and BDI.
So this is perhaps a correction, if you will? Is it?
Again?
Is this a correction?
Banking services.
Is this a correction of all of the rallies in the past weeks?
They've been the year-to-date best performers, and this is just a profit-taking on the part of the investors.
Okay, now April foreign investment outflows. That topic, outflows reaching $351 million in April. Now, what can change that course and improve inflows as we enter June?
Maybe after the jitters, we have this all the nervousness in the market now. Maybe after the issue on the Fed rate hike and then on the inflation data come April month end. And once all of these are resolved and we see inflation locally decelerating, and then the U.S. Fed and the debt ceiling resolving their differences, and then maybe the U.S. Fed coming to a terminal rate finally, 5.5%. So if all of these blow over, then the market could find some rest and begin to think through what's going to happen in the next second half of the year.
Okay, we're also ending the month, Christina. How do you evaluate the performance of the market for the month of May and even for June? What are your prospects? What is your outlook and perspective for the coming month?
I'd like to look at the year-to-date performance. We're very much flat versus the beginning of the year. We're down 0.50. I think it's down 0.50%. And that's if you're going to track the performance of our market in relative to the U.S. dollar, it's very much correlated. We started the year at like 56, the dollar was at 56 USD PHP, and the market was like at 6,500. Now it's the same story. It's 6,500, and the US dollar is at 56. So this correlation continues to play out, especially that the dollar is range bound. So the Philippine stock market may continue to be range bound too. We seem to be trapped in the range of like 6,400, 6,600. We're unable to go above 6,700, and that's really because of the we're still having this dollar strength continuing, and the U.S. recession is not happening, which is one thing that will prompt the Fed to cut interest rates. But that is a pushback. It seems that this is not what the market is thinking now. So going into June, I think the market should find rest and reprieve from all of the concerns in the coming weeks. And we look forward to the prospect that the second half will see the U.S. Fed keeping interest rates steady until the prospect of a recession comes into the picture, and then the odds of a cut in U.S. interest rates become rise to a higher probability. But that's going to be like towards year end.
All right. On that note, we thank you again for joining us, Christina Ulang of First Metro Investment Corporation. Thanks a lot for your market guidance.
Thank you. Thank you, Stanley. Bye-bye.